Dear participants, welcome to the 1 week online faculty development program on entrepreneurship, research, critical thinking and innovation. I am Dr. K. Krishnakumar, Associate Professor, Department of Commerce, Periyar University, Salem, Tamil Nadu. Today, I am going to talk about risk of business without research. As you know very well that a successful entrepreneur supposed to face and handle risks, because a high risk provides always high return. That's why understanding and handling the risks are the most important one. From that perspective, every entrepreneur should handle the risks and they supposed to keep on doing research on business risks. So, you know very well that no business is without risks. But the key to any business is understanding the importance of preventing, minimizing or eliminating the risks whenever possible in order to prevent losses. So, the ultimate purpose behind identifying and handling of any risk is to prevent, minimize and eliminating the risks. It is associated with the overall operation of any business unit or entity. So, risk is everywhere. In business particularly, risk is everywhere with related to, all the functional areas. A risk may be defined as an internal or external factor which may ultimately affect objectives of by either lowering the projected profits or even causing a loss. So, the risk is creating losses or lowering the profits. It may be due to economic issues, financial rates, industry regulations, business costs, breaches in information or potential influences, and it can cause a business to loss of money or ultimately go under. So, that handling the risk is very, very important, and also dealing with the risk is an unavoidable in any business. How to manage the risks? So, this is also another important aspect. By the way of effective risk management, a business can control and prevent the financial, political, social and cultural complexities associated with the risks, and it also allows a business to react accordingly and minimize or even prevent losses. Without identifying the risks or using risk management, a business cannot successfully define its objectives. So that it clearly denotes that. So for a formulation of objective itself, we need to conduct business risks. To conduct business risk analysis or business research. Then by minimizing or even eliminating risks, a business should see an increase in productivity by reduction of waste of time and resources, as well as protecting from any possible legal consequences, including intellectual property and so on. Here we are going to see types of risks. Basically, there are six types. We will see one by one. The first one is physical risks. It is a common physical risk of the business due to face of fire, water damage, due to flood, theft or vandalism. So, for repairing the physical damages or replacement of equipments and other physical units destroyed by the natural causes or something else, it needs a lot of investment and a lot of cost incurred with all those things. So, it is unavoidable. Strategy of physical risk is totally unavoidable. Every businessman is supposed to face at any situation. Then, strategic risk. The so-called decisions taken by any businessman or any enterprise or any entrepreneur, they are the whole overall responsible for the decisions taken by themselves. Sometimes it may not be worked out. under circumstances they supposed to fall, I mean, face the difficulties, are they supposed to face the losses, or and other consequences. Sometimes there may be a possibility of poor execution. Sometimes there may be a possibility of lack of resources. Sometimes the business environment can be changed. So these are all the things related to the strategic issues. The strategic issue means it is highly related to, that is called overall decision making process. So ultimately strategic risk leads to loss of profit, poor cash flow, low sales, and so on. Then the compliance risks. Every business is governed by some form of legislation and legal formalities and procedures and a set of rules. Sometimes, knowingly or unknowingly, there may be a possibility of, not adhering all those things, all those rules in a proper manner, all those guidelines in a proper manner, which may lead to legal compliances, and finally, the business unit is supposed to face fines, prosecutions, and reputational damages. So that also another important factor. It is related to compliance risks. Then human risks. So this risk is related with employees. Sometimes they may be misbehaving with the fellow employees, supervisors, subordinates, higher officials, or maybe sometimes something happened due to absenteeism, or even theft and other things. Sometimes outside the workplace also leads to some kind of damages to the business unit. So human risks. So that also unavoidable thing. And technological risk. Technology is the most important factor and the most important risk nowadays. From hardware to software, today we go to face a lot of difficulties because all the technology is updated day by day, and the software also updated day by day. Accordingly, the business unit is supposed to spend a lot of money, they are supposed to spend a lot of investment to develop technology and other, investment to modernization and equipping themselves to update all the, technological aspects. Sometimes the loss may be occurred due to systems failure, equipment failure, cyber attacks, malware attacks, and corruption, data manipulation, data theft, breach of data, and so on. So, particularly the companies related to IT, BPO, call centers, they are facing this kind of banking industry, insurance industry, they are facing a lot of difficulties with the reference to technology. And financial risks. There are a number of different ways are there in financial risks. Something may be internal, something may be external. Fluctuation in market, exchange rates, non-payment from the clients, and poor planning and projection and execution of financial policies and implications. So these are all the things leads to heavy loss, and sometimes it may be leads to negative cash flow, and sometimes the poor handling of business leads to end of the business. Apart from these six risks, there may be another risk that is called a natural risk. For example, now we are in lockdown situation due to COVID-19. So this is a situation where we are all supposed to stay in the home, and we are all staying in the home and working, and some of the industries, they are facing a lot of difficulties for running the business. So it is a highly an unavoidable circumstances which every business unit is supposed to follow. Then, whatever the thing, whatever risk is there, by the way of implementing effective risk management plan, risk can be properly managed. So here the five steps are there. identify potential risks, conduct risk analysis, identify warning signs, identify preventive measures, and assign responsibility. First of all, by the way of spending time to identify the specific risk faced by the business is the most important one. So, by the way of spending time to identify a specific risk is the most important, because some risks are universal. We supposed to face, and some risks may not be applied to us. It may be applied to some other business units or some other sectors. In that case, we go to find the potential risk of our unit. For that, we go to spend the time and identify the specific risk which is affecting our business. Then conduct risk analysis. This will help to classify and the priorities which risk is to treat as urgent. So risk analysis, we go to find the risks, and after identifying various risks, we go to conduct the risk analysis. Through the risk analysis, we can easily identify which one of the risk is, we should give much importance. And the next one is identify warning signs. So this is a key part of preventing risk. Identifying the warning sign of risk will reduce the burden of decision making process. Then identify preventive measures. Risk management plan is to be completed with identification of preventive measures to be taken for handling risks. So before going for handling the risk, we want to find to prevent the risks. Then assign responsibility. Each risk which is identified should be assigned with a responsible person who will be responsible for handling the risks. So risk cannot be handled with all the people. It should be handled by the responsible persons, so that handling the risk should be assigned to some responsible persons. Factors which are affecting business risks. Micro environmental factors. So micro environmental factors are the factors which are all highly or closely related with the business or company. The company goals, objectives, mission and the policies, the suppliers of the business unit, marketing intermediaries, customers, competitors, and the general publics. So these are all the people, those who are having directly linked with the business or closely linked with the business. So a business unit supposed to analyze very closely about these peoples. Macro environmental factors: demographic forces, economic forces, natural forces, technological forces, political forces, cultural forces. So these are all the forces we cannot control. A businessman cannot control it. This is beyond the control of any business. So that these forces also has to be identified and analyzed properly up to certain level. Research tools to be used for identifying businesses. SWOT analysis. Strength, weakness, opportunities, and threat analysis. Strength is strong internal aspects of the company relative to its competitors. For example, a business unit, they are having good resources capabilities, strong management, skilled workforce, etc. It may be called as strength of them. Then weaknesses. Weak internal aspects of the company relative to its competitors. So in comparison with the competitors, what are all the weaker points with the particular business unit? That is called the poor infrastructure, lack of system, poor management, etc. Then opportunities. Positive impacts from the external environment that a company could use to increase its sales and profits. So they have to find the opportunities available in the marketplace or the external environment for developing their sales, for improving their profits, etc. Then developing new market, developing new segment, developing new technology or innovating new technology, etc. Threats: negative impacts from the external environment that could decrease the company's sales and profits. It is called the whatever the reactions developed or created by the competitor against our action. That is called a threat. That is called competitor's actions, economic changes, political instability, etc. Then the resource-based approaches. Basically, a company should have three kinds of basic resources: tangible resources, intangible resources, and human resources. So, in the tangible resources, all kind of financial borrowing capacity, internal fund generation, etc. Then physical plant and equipment, location, technology, and raw materials, etc. All those things have to be properly analyzed. Then intangible: reputation of the company, brand name, customer base, relationship with the suppliers, relationship with the buyers, vendors, even company's shared values, company culture, etc. Then human resource: skill and knowledge of the manpower. Then motivation to the employee, flexibility and adaptation of the human resource at any circumstances, and the loyalty of the workforce or the manpower, those who are working in the particular business unit. So all the resource has to be properly analyzed, and through this kind of resource based approach we can find what are all the positives and what are all the negatives available with us. We can easily identify. Then pestle analysis. So this is a way of identifying the impact of political factors, economic factors, social factors, technological factors, legal factors, and environmental factors. Then spectacles analysis. So this is the analysis which is useful for identifying the social factors, political factors, economic factors, cultural factors, aesthetic factors, customers factors, legal factors, environmental factors, sectoral factors. So another one analysis is competitor analysis. So this analysis will be helpful for competitor identification, competitor assumptions, competitor objectives, competitor strategies, competitor capabilities. So this is also one of the important analysis which will be helpful for the movement and other strategies to be followed by the competitors in all the circumstances. Then various areas where the business research to be conducted. So apart from other things, the personnel department, the production or operations department, finance department, stores and warehousing department, logistics department, marketing department, quality control department, even these are all various areas where individual researches can be conducted with reference to the various functions of the particular departments or divisions. And other tools also to be used for business research are input-output analysis, cost-benefit analysis, gap analysis, forecasting, and ratio analysis. So these are all the analysis which will be helpful for identifying all kind of financial transactions, and what about the investment and expected return, and performance of standard and expected and standard performance, and standard and actual performance, and so on. Conclusion: the process of identifying risks, assessing the risks, and developing strategies to manage the risk is known as risk management. A risk management plan is an essential part of any business, as it helps to understand the potential risks to any business and identify ways to minimize them or recover from the impacts. It will be possible by the way of effective research, particularly with reference to various functional areas of business. The application of appropriate research tools will be extract the maximum possible outputs to avoid or reduce the risks in any business operations. Thank you all.